At 4:49, our time right now, Dave Nussbaum here as we are starting off for a morning with some quiet weather. Of course, all eyes are on Hurricane Delta as it works its way closer to Cancun this morning. Right now, though, you can see here and in town, nothing really to worry about yet. We'll be watching things change over the course of the next couple of days, though, as we move forward here. We're still going to be dealing with, again, potentially the landfall here of a major hurricane on Louisiana as we head into Friday and into early on Saturday. Now, we begin our morning warm and a little bit muggy, 71 in Slidell, 70 in Hammond, 77 in town and 72 degrees in the Houma area. But what we're looking at the latest with Delta now remains the same with the forecast track with Cancun today and likely Louisiana as we get into Friday. Now the strength will get stronger once it gets back in the Gulf of Mexico with a slight weakening by landfall, but nothing too significant. So we'll definitely be watching that. I'll show you that in a bit. And that landfall Friday night into Saturday morning looks like in southwest Louisiana to south central there as maybe a category-3 major hurricane. Right now, though, you can see here again, winds are 115, so it is a little weaker from the category-4 it was yesterday, battling a little bit of some wind shear there. It's not a perfectly symmetric system or hurricane anymore. It is moving quickly, though, northwest at 17. That's some good news for the Cancun area and the Yucatan Peninsula with the pressure there up to 972, about 35 miles there east northeast of Cozumel, Mexico. Now you can see here where it's located, but watching a couple features, we'll talk about it in a minute, a little trough of low pressure over the western part of the country. That's what's eventually going to help to turn it northward and impact our area as we head toward the end of the week. So again, looking at those storms continue to work its way across Cancun and just briefly going over that far kind of northeastern tip of the Yucatan Peninsula there. We're going to get down to a 3 to a category-2 briefly there in the Gulf of Mexico, back to a category-3 though as we head on into tomorrow afternoon, and then even up to a category-4 hurricane as we head on into the day there as we go on into Thursday afternoon into Friday morning with winds around 130 miles per hour. So it looks like just off of our coastline here, we'll be dealing with potentially a category-4 hurricane. Now there is some cooler water immediately along the coastline, and this is likely going to be a fairly large hurricane at this point as well. Big wind field from this expanding its way all the way from Houston to New Orleans and beyond. So with that in mind, it's not going to be sitting over water there. The cooler water is very long. It's going to be moving fairly quickly, enough for it to weaken down to a category-3 you see there as we get to about 1 o'clock on Friday. But Friday evening there, that's when it should make landfall somewhere, say, in your intercoastal city, maybe Louisiana. Still could vary. You can see the forecast cone does go all the way to Texas-Louisiana border, all the way to New Orleans. So still little wiggle room for this to move on through. And then we get to a tropical storm by 1 o'clock on Saturday, but definitely likely a major hurricane making landfall there, dangerously close to where Laura was located just a few weeks ago. And then it continues, of course, weaken across the midsection of the country as well, too, as it heads toward the northeast. So what we're looking at here, though, you can see the forecast model's pretty much in agreement here. They do spread up a little bit as we get toward landfall, but to still have a pretty good agreement with it. So that's why we're looking at potentially just off to the west of us. We'll see what happens once it gets in the Gulf of Mexico to get a better idea what this system may do. Now, what's staring at higher high pressure sitting over part of Florida? That's helping to turn it there to the northeast. And then eventually here, you'll see a trough coming on in. That'll pull it to the north as it's a category-4 and across Louisiana here as we head on into Friday afternoon where it does weaken down to a 3 and then continues its way northward here as that trough moves on through and out of our area. So we'll be watching that. Now it is looking over warm waters in the mid 80s here, but there you see the slightly cooler waters along our coastline, and you can see oceanic heat content is really warm down here in the Caribbean, not as warm here, but still warm enough to make it a little bit stronger. So definitely be watching that. Potential rainfall totals here across southeast Louisiana. You can see the worst of it will be there over the western part of the state. They're talking 6, 7, 8 inches of rain. We're talking maybe about 2 to 6 inches of rain across our area moving forward. So throughout today, nothing too significant. Mix of sun and clouds, warm or humid, little breeze, temperatures in the mid 80s, and our chance of rain increases up to 90% there by Friday before decreasing by Sunday to nothing. So today we're looking at a couple of showers, some cloud cover out there that continues on into Thursday morning. And then as we go forward here on into Thursday afternoon, some of these storms coming in, we need to watch out for a few of these potentially producing a few tornadoes. And then as we head on into Friday morning, again, outer rain bands, potentially a couple of tornadoes. There you see potentially the storm moving on in toward the this model saying the Lake Charles area. But nonetheless, though, some of the heavy rain moving in during the day Friday, Friday night into Saturday across our area. So that's when things will start to go downhill Friday into Saturday morning. So today not looking too bad. Still time to get storm preps done. Biggest takeaway is going to be storm surge for us. We need to watch out for that, and the weather does improve next week.